Hey all, so here is a video on relief art. This video is generally for the beginners. So this art is made in different ways, but here I'm going to share an easy method, that is by creating layer on overlapping layers. In this video you will watch a single layer relief and a double layer relief. Let's check the things we will need. The first step is to prepare the texture paste. The texture paste is made up of plaster of Paris plus water plus white glue. It has to be in the ratio of 1:1:1. Mix it well and the paste should be in a running form like you can see. Now apply this paste on the base which you are using. It can be apply canvas or any hardboard. Apply it all over. Let it dry. After it get dry, now the second step is to draw your design on the base. You can use carbon for help, or if you are good in sketching, you can directly draw your sketch on the base. If you are doing it for the first time, try to make some bold design. After sketching, it's time to prepare the cone. After preparing the cone, you have to make the paste, the texture paste, and it has to be in the ratio of 2:1:1, that is 2 tablespoons of POP, 1 tablespoon of water and 1 tablespoon of white glue. Mix it well and fill it in the cone. Do it as fast as possible. So now, without wasting any time, apply this paste on your design. Fill the design as soon as possible because the paste don't take much time to get dry. So the first layering is done, and let it dry for at least 2 hours. After drying, it will look somewhat like this. So here is a small difference of one layer of relief painting. Relief painting is created by layering on an overlapping layer. So this is one layer of relief, and this is a relief with two layers. On the second layer, you can fill all over, or you can also just give a border by applying the same paste, texture paste. So you can see the difference. This will give much more embossed look to the design. So coming back to the design, now we have to make a fresh texture paste for the second layer. So the first layer get dry. After this, you have to fill the cone once again with a fresh texture paste and apply it all over the design. And as I have said, you can also use by just giving borders by a thin border, but here I am applying it all over. While applying, make sure that you wet your fingers, and wherever you will be applying your paste, just dab your wet finger on the design so that no crack can be formed, and it will give a smooth look. So here I have completed the second layer also, and now I have to keep this for drying. I will keep it for 5 hours maximum. It get dry fast, so 5 hours is okay. After it get dry, it's time for coloring it. So I'm using a brown, yellow and white color for the base, not for the design. For the design, I will be using plain silver color. Thank you. So it's done. Thank you for watching.